the shepherds. A strong flash awakened some shepherds. The smallest of them went out the door and pointing to the sky, shouted, "It's an angel. It is a today in Bethlehem with great wings. Let us kneel before the angel of God." And hovering in the air, he said, "Fear not. I announce to you a great joy for Israel and for all the peoples of the earth today. In the city of David the Savior was born, Jesus Christ." On the outskirts of Bethlehem, before finding a poor stable, a boy wrapped in swaddling clothes, because for the Messiah no roof was found in the city of David. In that hour thousands and thousands of angels came from heaven, singing, "Glory to God in the biggest and on earth peace to men of good will." Celestial anthem that greeted the Creator, descended into the world as a human creature. As they returned to heaven, the voices and lights dimmed, and shepherds gradually returned to normal. Little Levi remembered that he had pointed out a cave to a pregnant young woman. "I even gave her a pot of milk. She's so young and beautiful. She looks like a girl with a jasmine face lit up by the moon. But they must be poor and hungry. Let's take everything we can." They gathered everything they had, eggs, cheese, tanned skins, and even a nursing lamb. And they wondered, "But how can the Savior be born in such a place?" They arrived at the cave without the courage to enter. Levi, who saw the angel first and was called crazy, did not flinch. He went ahead to spy. And he was ecstatic. "I see the young woman leaning over the manger, and the child crying, and he hear her singing, 'Little Jesus, your mother's love. What a pain to see you cry, Dotto. If I had milk, but I still don't have any.'" Seeing them at the entrance with torches in their hands, Joseph asked, "Who are you?" "We are shepherds. We have come to bring you food and worship the Lord. It was the angel who warned us." Mary recognized Levi and smiled with a gesture. She invited everyone inside and brought the boy to the manger. "Come here, honey. This is the Son of God." The baby Jesus cried from hunger and from cold, and the most courageous said, "Take it, mother. This heapskin would belong to my son who is about to beben. It is soft and clean. Wrap it around your son." Then they offered him freshly drawn milk. Mary, with the tip of her mantle, wet his lips with warm foam. The little baby, sucking on the creamy sweetness, fell asleep on the spot. Concerned about the situation, the shepherds wanted to help. "You cannot stay here. It is too cold and it is damp. Tomorrow we'll talk to our mistress. She's good. She has a full house, but she'll take you in." "Courage, mother. You will lack nothing. We are poor shepherds and four now. Take what our poverty can offer you." Joseph replied, "We're also poor. We will not be able to pay you back." "Oh no, the Lord has already paid us. Thingles promised peace to those of goodwill. This child has already given it to us. We know that he will be the prince of peace and must be worshipped. And you, mother, who begot Son of God, are holy. Give us your orders. We will be Philistine to serve you. What can we do for you? Love my son, and always feel in your heart what you feel now. But for you, what do you desire? Have you no relatives? Yea, Zacharias and Isabel, my cousin, but they live in Hebron. We will go there when know that you are willaged after all." And each one spoke his name: Elijah, Levi, Samuel, Jonah, Isaac, Tobias, Jonathan, Daniel, Simeon, John, Joseph and his twin brother Benjamin. 12 in all, dot with different ages, most of them being teenagers. Excited to say goodbye, Levi asked to kiss his clothes. Mary, sitting on the hay, smiled. She lifted the little one forth them to kiss his little feet. At that moment, he cried, touched by the numerous grace. They left burning with love, leaving their hearts tear. They were the first worshippers of the body of Jesus, and they teach us a lot. They had faith, generosity, humility, desire to help, and lots of love. Jesus tells Voltorta, notice to whom the angel revealed himself first, and deserve the Mary's caresses. Levi, whoever has the soul of a child, has the courage to ask Mary, let me kiss, because it is always Mary who gives you Jesus.